Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Saturday, Feast of St. Lawrence, Deacon and Martyr. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. This is the Blessed Lawrence who gave himself up for the treasure of the Church. For this he earned the suffering of martyrdom to ascend with joy to the Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father. You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. O God, giver of the ardor of love, for you, by which St. Lawrence was outstandingly faithful in service and glorious in martyrdom, grant that we may love what he loved and put into practice what he taught. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each must do as already determined, without sadness or compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. Moreover, God is able to make every grace abundant for you, so that in all things, always having all you need, you may have an abundance for every good work. As it is written, he scatters abroad, he gives to the poor, his righteousness endures forever. The one who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed and increase the harvest of your righteousness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands. His posterity shall be mighty upon the earth. The upright generation shall be blessed.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands.
Well for the man who is gracious and lends, who conducts his affairs with justice. He shall never be moved. The just one shall be in everlasting remembrance.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
An evil report he shall not fear. His heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. His heart is steadfast. He shall not fear till he looks down upon his foes.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Lavishly he gives to the poor. His generosity shall endure forever. His horn shall be exalted in glory.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Alleluia, alleluia. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life, says the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it, and whoever hates his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also will my servant be. The Father will honor whoever serves me. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now today we celebrate the Feast of St. Lawrence, no martyr, no? Again, I'd like to invite you to again continue to reflect on our faith, no? On our faith journey. And then this time we have the faith of the martyr, no? Which is very, very much symbolized in what the Lord was saying, no? Again, going back to that dying to self, no? And the first point that I will invite you to look at is to die and to give life. Now, the image that the Lord uses in today's gospel, no, is that a seed must fall to the ground and die so that it will give life. So that first point to reflect on. And then the second is that, again, the Lord sets here the context of service and discipleship, no, in this gospel passage. Then finally, I'd like to say, as a final word of our reflection, is just to say something about St. Lawrence, no? So first about the dying that one may give life, no? When you take a look at this image that the Lord uses, no, it's really the pattern of nature. It is the cycle of life in nature, no? That's why even the mystery of the cross and resurrection really is built on that pattern of, no, of dying and coming to life, dying and that coming to life, which is really a natural pattern in nature, no? But I think here, no, it gives us a pattern of Christian life, no? That the pattern of Christian life is such that, you know, that it is the dying to self, no, that allows us to give birth, no, to life and grace, especially in the service of others, no? And I think we've experienced that, no? We've experienced that a lot, no? The moment we are able to give of ourselves, the moment we're able to sacrifice ourselves, no? There's a certain life that is brought, no, in the people that we serve, no? And I think this is something that would be good to reflect on and to ask ourselves, almost like, no, remember that consciousness examine of Ignatius, that you try to see the good that you did and also the shortcomings that you committed, no, or the wrong things that you committed, and to look at it, no, to look at it and then to be able to see, no, the pattern of the movements, no, and then also to be able to see how can you die to self more and more, no, so that you may give life to the good things, no, and that is also the way to overcome our shortcomings, no, and I guess this is very central to our Christian faith, no, because that is the central mystery of our faith, the dying on the cross and the coming to life in the resurrection, no, and precisely the offering of Christ, no, the grain falling to the ground to bear fruit, is seen in that pattern of the central mystery of our faith, the cross and resurrection. No? And then very much related to this is that the Lord now makes this the context of service and the context of discipleship. No? That it is precisely in the denial of oneself, no, and then the giving up, no, of our life that we are able to become true servants of Christ, no? That you're able to become true disciples of Christ, no? It's almost like this is your foundational element, no? This is the ground on which we build up our life of service and our life of discipleship, no? And then the third and last point is just to say something about St. Lawrence, no? And what I want to highlight is the letter of Paul, no, wherein the Lord Paul says the Lord loves a cheerful giver, no? And most certainly Lawrence was known for that. Remember, he was the one who was being roasted, no? He was martyred by being roasted. Then he supposedly tells his executioner, could you turn me a little bit, no? So that my cooking would be very well done, no? In the sense that you have equal heat all over, no? So really, even at the point of death, no, he cheerfully offers his life. And again, cheerfully, almost like forgiving, no, his executioner through a joke, no? And I guess there's much to say about that, no? As I always say, people are attracted to people who are, as we say in Filipino, yung magaan, no? Na I think that for me, that is proven, no? Pag magaan yung pagkatao mo, you attract more people, no? And people feel more comfortable with you. So I think that is one very concrete application of that the Lord loves a cheerful giver. And precisely because of that, a cheerful person, a cheerful giver attracts more people, no?
So again, that point to reflect on, no? Nakakaakit yung ano eh, yung pagiging magaan at masaya ng isang tao. At siguro tingnan din natin ulit itong dalawang punto ng pag-aalay ng sarili, no? Ang unang punto nga ay yung ginamit na imahe ng Panginoon na kailangan mamatay para magbigay buhay, no? Yan ang ano, yan ang masasabi natin, yan ang galaw, no, ng kalikasan, no? Kamatayan, muling pagkabuhay, kamatayan, muling pagkabuhay. Kahit 'di ba, kahit sa lalo na dun sa mga sa four seasons, 'di ba? Kitang-kita yung ganung pattern, eh. So yun ang sinasabi rin ng Panginoon, ano, na kailangan mamatay para magbunga, no? Hangga't hindi ang isang binhi, no, ay nahuhulog sa lupa at nagbubunga, wala siyang ano, no, wala siyang naibabahagi, no. At yung pangalawang punto na kaugnay din nito, ito ang konteksto ngayon ng paglilingkod at pagiging disipulo, no. Ang kung tutusin mo, parang ang patuloy na conversion, no, ng dying and coming to life. And then, yun ang nagbibigay sa atin ng pagpapalalim ng ating pagkatao, pagpapalalim ng ating spiritualidad, ano. So today, as we in a sense have this final installment also on reflecting on our faith, let us again ask ourselves, no, how much we are going through that pattern in our day-to-day life, no, the pattern of the cross and resurrection, the pattern of dying and coming to life, the pattern of dying and bearing fruit, no, and fruits that we share with others. As we celebrate the feast day of a great saint of the Church of Rome, Mother of all churches, let us beseech our loving Father to grant the requests we make together in prayer.
That the deacons of the Church may be zealous in their ministry of preaching the gospel by word and example. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That there may be enough Catholic volunteers to work for poor communities or nations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may value and protect our poor as real treasures of the Church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let's continue to pray for all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. We also continue to pray for the good health of the Holy Father, for his quick recovery from his recent procedure. Let's also pray for his intentions, especially for his prayers for peace. Let's also continue to pray for the victims of Typhoon Karina, and also for those who are affected by the floods. And let's also pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, the offerings we joyfully make on the feast day of Saint Lawrence, and grant that they become a help to our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyr, Saint Lawrence, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to become heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer the Oratio Imperata for peace.
God, our Heavenly Father, Lord of peace and justice, we humbly come before you during this time of escalating geopolitical tensions in our part of the world. Through the years, you have sustained our faith in you as a nation. It is our faith in your divine providence that has made us survive the countless natural and human-caused calamities that have come our way in our history as a people. Spare us, Lord, from the horrors of war. Hear our pleas as we cry out to you. Have mercy on us, Lord. Rescue us from the malevolent forces that influence world leaders. For we believe that our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. We pray for our leaders entrusted with making crucial decisions for our nation. We place all our hopes in you, seeking your forgiveness and mercy for the times when our fears and suspicions have tainted our perceptions with ethnic biases and prejudices verging on racism. We earnestly pray, Lord, that you make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us bring love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady, Queen of Peace,
pray for us.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Francis of Assisi,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Loyola,
pray for us. And let us pray. Nourished by these sacred gifts, we humbly implore you, Lord, that the homage of dutiful service which we render on the feast of Saint Lawrence may bring us an increase of your saving grace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat, and again, have a good day and have a good weekend also. Thank you.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.